Nino Russo this morning opened this workshop full of events with a conference about the scientific activity of Nino Baron. Now, this evening, I'm closing a full day full of events with a conference about the scientific activities of Baron. This is not strange. Symmetry is an important factor in life. Anyway, I will not repeat the things said by very well by Nino, speaking of other things. In fact, there are a lot of things of interest in the life of Vincenzo. I think about this in the past days a lot. I make a short selection, not too long, but starting from the very beginning and arriving until now, or also in the next future. Starting from the very beginning, Baron's date of birth allowed him to avoid a trap for young chemists in Italy. Wishing to work in theoretical chemistry in the preceding years. What was important was compulsory to spend so many years doing other things, and then later could we pass to theoretical chemistry. He started immediately with the theoretical chemistry. And he started quite well with working, traveling, and giving a lot of paper in a short period. This fact is easier to be accepted by the university or the universities, the different universities in which you had contact, to be accepted by the other people. If you look at the titles of the papers published by Baron in these initial years, it turns out quite evident what were the scientific interests of different people working in the surrounding. Looking with more attention to the text, an average of very good quality, comes out evident the variety of methodological approaches, the quality of the results, and the significant number of co-authors. Most of them are no expert in theoretical chemistry. This shows that Enzo did not refuse the role then considered the most important for the principal one for theoreticians in chemistry, set to give explanation or interpretation of findings considered important by some other people who did some experiments. People with, in general, with limited knowledge in theoretical chemistry. This was the motivation which led universities in Italy to accept, after the war, a number of, a very limited number indeed, of theoreticians in the academic structure of chemistry. The task was to write papers on demand. The task of giving an explanation to phenomena singled out by experimentalists actually is a very difficult, a very unpleasant work. The instrument of format, the instrument and the computational analysis were quite limited, not sufficient to give satisfactory descriptions and explanation of phenomena of complex nature. To get results of some scientific interest, there was the need of remarkable mental agility, a good capability of convincing the interested people to reformulate the demand in a form leading to a study with some perspective of positive results. These qualities are not common. The best I know case, the less I know, is that of Linus Pauling. Linus Pauling was a master in reformulation of problems. Many among Baron's papers I have just mentioned have the same aspect, so showing quality in answer of this type. There is emphasize that the Barone papers, I just considered now, have nothing, absolutely nothing to do with a lot of the papers published in these years, consisting in a selection of publication of numbers, some numbers, and with no interpretation of the numbers, no analysis of that. So it's a sort of literature quite abundant, but not too important. Barone, in fact, avoided this ability, the trap of the garbage literature, and initiated to improve the computational description of chemical, physical, geochemical and physical phenomena. I selected three subjects within this activity, starting at that time and arriving until now. One was the computational methodology. The second, the description of the response properties. The third, the advance in realism in the description of the properties. In the specific case, the medium in which the properties is measured. According to Barone, the calculation have to be performed with methods permitting refinements, because there was the computers that were increasing in quality, so it was possible to have a perspective of improving the results later in the future. And for this reason, the use of ab initio methods was compelling. At the same time, the methods were to be improved under every aspect. So the not time to dig more the details, but I just mentioned that the Barone did in this year very large number of studies on several points of this program. Many efforts were done, especially for the improvement of density functional techniques. Well, the attention paid to this particular aspect, that functional, is characteristic, in my opinion, of Barone's style. Ab initio calculation of the artifactual level, very rightly considered often not sufficient for the degree of accuracy necessary to satisfy his requirements. A calculation of higher precision, as Kapler-Klaus calculation of high level, were impossible or otherwise extremely costly. There was only a practical possibility that the use of the intermediate level that the necessary functional. And in fact, Barone did a lot of work in the improvements of the density functional, which was possible to improve, but also to use immediately. That was the important point, not only a theoretician of the technique, but a working scientist. Barone shifted at that time, for the moment, the passage to higher calculation. To remark that this moment is not yet arrived now. Do you agree? Yeah. Well, I repeat, yeah, time is faster, you have to pass on. To perform an accurate analysis of computer molecular properties is not sufficient is not sufficient to rely on the examination of published experiments. But more in intimate knowledge of the acts to be performed in passing from a collection of measured values to a publication of the paper is strongly recommended, in some cases necessary. Barone did so just at the beginning of the scientific career, while elaborating papers on the demand for the colleagues, Naples and other university around him, he spent long periods of time at one of the best European laboratories in spectroscopy. It was Grant, he is no more present, he was just a member of that is important. It was one of the best laboratories on the subject. The long, many years, strict contact with the activities of this laboratory enabled Barone to reach a degree of confidence with a measure of complex molecular response properties rarely found at this level in other theoreticians. Barone exploited later, and is exploited now, the confidence with his experimental measurements. One of the topics considered in these lines of the research is the computer description of the anharmonic components of molecular vibration. Barone is working now, so, but they were working also 20 years ago, if you remember well. Well, vibrations are not a subject limited to infrared spectroscopy, but have influence on all the other molecular response functions. The anharmonicity is often considered to be just a refinement on a property essentially defined at the lower level, the theory, the harmonic level. Actually, for some properties, anharmonic contributions have an impact that cannot be defined in a simple refinement, and in some cases, it is just the main component of the response. Barone's project of progressively enlarging the number of properties considered in its work of producing computational complex procedures proceeds steadily, but other aspects of the problem of computer molecular response properties were to be kept into considerations. Single molecules in general interact with others, and the response property of a single isolated molecule, although formally perfectly definable, in practice turned out to be an ideal concept. Experimentalists have struggled to extract true molecular response function from their measurements. Generally, they resort to use of approximations and of molecular models horrifying professional theoreticians for their arbitrariness and lack of precision. The only reasonable way to overcome this impasse is to resort to computation performed at a higher level, including interaction with the medium described at a necessary level of accuracy. That was the main road. So I pass now to the next step, the last step of my exposition, the interaction of molecules with external media, which is also the reason justifying my presence here to draw a scientific portrait of Enzo. I am considered older than Enzo, 18 years of difference. I was always interested in following the work of younger colleagues and to give them advice when possible. Enzo was without doubt one of the most promising guys of this age, the best perhaps. And I follow with interest the evolution of his research. I repeated to Enzo several times the concept I have just said about the importance of the medium. Enzo naturally agreed. It seems to, at present evident that everybody should be agree with this concept, but that is not true. I have found a lot of objections or idea of including the medium in the study of molecules. Well, the simplest approach was to start with ideal solutions containing a single molecule with a simple homogeneous liquid. Was already done the interaction between two or three molecules, but the whole liquid not yet. Enzo explored several methodologies recent publication, changing salt property, but with results not fully satisfactory. And so, after a while, I convinced him to take my course. So, this was the beginning of an intense collaboration with Enzo. The beginning was extremely active in checking, refining the codes and to put them in a form easier to be used by other members of the scientific community. I'm very, very grateful to Enzo for this work. we established a connection with Gaussian. Mike Frisch gave us money and technical support, two items very important for two groups. The inclusion of the solvation codes within Gaussian greatly helped the fusion. Partly in common, partly separately, we greatly extended our solvation codes in taking into account mean auto and medium effects, non-equilibrium, local heterogeneity, just to give two examples, but there are just two examples, there are many other kinds. A large variety of different descriptions of the solvent, just what they had done, said, allows a better description of many spectroscopic properties. For example, non-equilibrium solvent is necessary to give a realistic picture of emission absorption process or radiant energy in the traditional and also non-traditional spectroscopies. Local heterogeneity, to give the second example, just to give a local example, expressed in terms of limited cluster of solid molecules treated at the quantum level, which gives a sufficient realistic description of subject effects, electronic effects, substantial electronic effects of the chromophore of the molecule, evidenced by some spectroscopies, among which, for example, the nuclear magnetic resonance. So, okay, this in which this was necessary. Well, the collaboration between Hans and me, so between Naples and Pisa, continued in the strict manner for about 3 or 4 years. And then in more relaxed form, with work performed in parallel, sometimes the same subject, sometimes on different subjects, related to the presence of the dense medium. The numbers of topics for which it is interesting to necessary to use computational models containing description of a dense phase is enormous. It's not possible to make an to give an overview. And also large the number of methods giving the description of such a dense media. And so explored a number of such techniques, arriving among other achievements at the definition of new version for hybrid methods, continuum discrete, for the solvent, quantum classic for the material component in the model. In these studies, also followed with a couple of additional drives in the methodology, the style of his first years, namely the selection of the of chemical problem of interest for somebody out of this group, but also suited for our need of testing a new method, a new parameters. So was okay. The experience gained in such a way is considerably amply sufficient to support an action promoted by Arezzo, which we have just had at least in exposition now, an action promoted by Arezzo, executed by his group, consisting in the building of the foundation of a multipurpose virtual spectrometer. I've spent now a few words to speak about this point, some comments, and then I close it. Okay. Spectroscopic measurements are a key contribution to almost all scientific activities involving molecular matter. The number of techniques is rapidly increasing. The number of properties passing from the stage of hypothetical plausible quantities to actually measurable observables is also increasing. And that also increases the potential information derived from spectroscopic measurements. The problem is that new instruments are generally expensive, and the increase in the number of instruments available in the laboratory requires more space, higher maintenance costs, and additional skills on your operators. Well, this being the situation, Barone's idea is or providing a suite of programs dedicated to simulate on a computer all kinds of spectroscopic measurements with a full control of the possible external conditions having an influence on spectroscopic signal. You may see just an example, the beginning of that. Clearly, a very accurate description of all aspects of the measure is necessary. A very accurate description of the solvent, the effects on the property, is of course important, an important ingredient, but for the kind of spectrometers, but it's not really unique. Among the missing elements, some are still to be better completely defined from the viewpoint of computational technology. This is the reason explaining my using my word to put the foundation and not on already full operational suite. But on the group are still to work hard to complete the suite. But the end for a working instrument is not terribly far. Well, this action represents a clearly defined step in the use of computers for quantum mechanical studies. It's a momentous, an important moment, this one. I just signaled this aspect, which is possible to say a lot of things, make more considerations, without entering into comments. To emphasize the meaning of this innovation. But I spent just the last few minutes to close the page with a remark on what I have just said. The experiment gained by Enzo in the reproduction and the dissection of molecular phenomena in the disparate fields is large enough. In the years, I've done studies on a lot of things. Large enough to allow the start-up of other actions similar to that of the spectrometer. But addressing other properties and other fields of the scientific realm, also out of chemistry. Barone has the stamina to do it, the necessary expertise, and a larger group of motivated young students, co-workers, should be well accepting the perspective of contributing to another significant step of progress in the comprehension, in the computer description of the molecular, submolecular work. It will be a great thing if Enzo will decide to do it. Yes.
Okay, I have nothing to add except to thank very, very much Jacopo for our long-standing friendship, my long-standing appreciation of his work, and especially of his philosophy, which inspired me along the whole career. I consider Jacopo one of my two reference persons. The other one is Giuseppe De Re, with whom I had my degree in Naples, and the second one was Jacopo. Actually, there are three, because the third one is Robert Subra in Grenoble, who teaches me EPR spectroscopy and magnetic properties. So that I always... I have always been inspired by Jacopo in different terms, even in the few instances in which we disagree on some point. But even this disagreement was inspiring for my work and the obtainment of new results. Apart from that, I have to thank all of you, the old friends and the new one, and I just want to say that even if you hope the contrary will continue to work, and I will continue to try to find new ideas and new inspirations, and to see that here young students and young postdocs are very, very high quality. I hope to have something to tell and to teach them, even if I'm not sure of that. But when I will be convinced that they have nothing more to teach or to discuss, I will stop my career. Thank you again, and please proceed for the last thing of the day, which is a short meeting with something to drink, essentially. Thank you very much.